clean hands and a pure heart. He will receive blessing from the Lord.
Is this the truth?
So the story of Jesus is already foretold in the Old Testament. From Abraham will be born a nation, a people chosen by God, a people who will demonstrate through their misconduct that it must await the one promised to come. Genesis chapter 22. And the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, declares the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you, and I will surely multiply your offspring as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in your offspring shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice."
Thank you. Thank you.
was Mary. In humble submission to the will of the Lord, she rejoices as the servant of the Lord. How will this be? And the angel explains the miracle that would take place in her womb, the miracle of the incarnate Christ in the womb of a virgin. A reading from Luke chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man who was named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. He came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
Thank you.
that all the world should be registered. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." And the angels went away from them to heaven. The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Please be seated.
Gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, departed to their own country by another way.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to bear witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believe in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but born of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as the one and only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
place and to place in the arms of a mother the gift of your Son. We confess that by our sin we insult his innocence. By our doubts we mock his trust of your word. By our selfishness we make light of his sacrifice. Forgive us and renew in us trust in your love and grace through your most holy Son. Hallow this night, Lord, that it may be your holy night for us. Help us hear your angels speak through your word, that we may no longer live in fear. Lead us to listen to the gospel, your good news, that we may know your Son, born to us, the Savior Christ, the Lord. Open our hearts to hear the mighty choirs sing of all your promises, that we may see your glory in the highest, in Christ's humble birth, and your peace for us and for all men in his lowly coming. Let him who once was born be born anew for us this night. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you